Welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about VidCon again. But I want to share with you guys what I learned from VidCon and what I learned about VidCon. I want to share some of the tips and tricks that I learned from the sessions I went to, from the other creators that I met, and also what I learned about the event in general as a whole, the whole thing. So that if you want to go next year or the year after that, you have a rough idea of what you can expect, because you can expect a lot. So just to prove that I was there, I do have my badge still, even though you can literally watch my vlog. Before VidCon starts, if you register before a certain date, they will mail you all of your, they call them credentials, I think is what they call them. So they send you your badge and your wristband. I cut them apart because I thought they were special and I wanted to keep something. You cannot lose these two things.
Don't lose it.
My mom came to VidCon with me, and when they mailed us our wristbands, they put them together. We each had our own. They didn't specify whose was whose. So that's a big flaw that I noticed. I ended up wearing her wristband. She had mine. Her wristband that I was wearing got too tight, so I had to cut it off and go back the next day and buy another one for $20.
Bad news. I had to cut it off because I made it too tight.
As I was networking with other creators, they would say,
"Oh, hey, what's your channel name?"
And I was just like, another thing about VidCon is that you need to expect to leave with more than what you came with. Thank God they give us these. I have 3 pairs of sunglasses. Why do I need these? I don't need this many sunglasses, but now I have them. And they were all free. I also got a free shirt, and most of them are stickers. I got pins. I only bought 3 things while I was at VidCon. Can you guess what they were? Stickers and pins! We'll just add it to my collection on my water bottle.
You can get this sticker at my merch store. The link will be in the description.
Go for the creator badge because it opens so many more doors for you. Stick with a buddy system. It's not fun by yourself. I was fortunate enough to know somebody that was already going, and we met up and we spent the entire 3 days together. VidCon is so much more fun when you go with somebody. We ended up making friends with other creators, and it really changed the entire atmosphere for all of us. Making a friend will change the entire situation for you. Creators help creators. Now I'm in a group chat with like 15 other creators that I met from going to one networking session, and we're constantly promoting our videos to each other, asking each other for ideas and help. Networking is so important in this community. A big thing about VidCon is pretty much promoting yourself. VidCon is literally so helpful. One thing that I really loved about VidCon is it gives you an opportunity to work and speak with a lot of creators that have potentially a much larger following than yourself. So getting that time with people who are making money doing this and that are experienced and have been doing it for years is so helpful to those of us who haven't been doing it for as long. Those kinds of moments happen throughout the entire weekend. I had no idea that Saturday was the busiest day of VidCon. The parking lot was full. I spent probably another half an hour just trying to find parking. It took me about another half an hour to get into the convention, and that's also a lot of walking. So be prepared to walk a lot. In those 3 days, I walked 25 miles. How long is a marathon?
The answer I found is 138,435 feet.
How long is a marathon in miles?
The answer is 26.22 miles.
So in those 3 days at VidCon, I was 1 mile short of walking a marathon. And this about VidCon is more of a tip from my mom. And she's told me this for everything. It is what you make it. VidCon will be an experience that you will never forget if you make it the experience that you will never forget. By the time Monday hit, I was like, oh my gosh, I miss spending time with these people. I made it as memorable as possible. I tried to sneak in a couple places. So we're gonna kind of try to like sneak around a little bit.
Hi.
Granted, it didn't work, but like, at least I tried. VidCon is what you make it. Like, there are things about VidCon that I never in a million years would have thought have happened. I got recognized for the first time. If you would like to see my VidCon vlog, that will be linked somewhere. You can see who I met, how I met them, and just how much fun it was. With all that being done and said, I want to say thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, give it a big old thumbs up. And if you want to see more content, maybe like this, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell right next to it so that you never miss one of my posts, which are every Sunday at noon PST. I would love to get your guys' opinion on whether I should be posting more often or not. And if you guys would like for that, let me know in the comments. I read every single comment that's left here on my channel. And I love you. Thank you for everything. And I will see you in my next video. Bye! If you're wondering why I'm like kind of glammed up and like dressed up, it's because I am going to the concert of my dreams. I am gonna go see Queen on the Rhapsody tour. I have been dreaming of seeing Queen since I was like 7. Oh, you think you can love me?